Thank you. Singer Chaka Khan was scheduled to perform in the Grammy tribute to Whitney Houston last night, but backed out because she was too distraught. KCAL 9's Ryan Fidel talked to Khan tonight, along with the owners of the club where Houston performed on Thursday night. And Soraya, they're saying that everyone was wrong about Houston's behavior that night. Soraya.
Well, that's right. Many people out here tell me she really performed and really carried herself as a seasoned professional. Chaka Khan tells me tonight that she adored Whitney Houston and loved her like a sister. And those who saw her for the last time here at this Hollywood club behind me tell me that they are just stunned by the news and they're speaking for the first time.
She sounded incredible, like she's always sounded. It was like, wow, there's Whitney right there, and it was effortless.
Tonight we're learning more about Whitney Houston's final public performance prior to Grammy weekend.
She was elegant, she looked fantastic as she arrived in great spirits.
For the first time, True Club in Hollywood shows us where the stage was set when she came to support her Grammy nominee friend Kelly Price.
The night itself was a celebration of R&B. Just an honor and a pleasure to have her here, you know, in our venue. The night just went smoothly.
Houston's last performance was an impromptu duet with Price.
She was not high. I'm a girl that grew up in the projects in New York City. I know high when I see it. She was not high.
We're told the pre-Grammy event Thursday night was packed and hot inside. Video obtained by Entertainment Tonight shows Houston getting irritated with paparazzi outside as she left the club.
Whitney, how's it going?
Bring all the good and happy times.
Close friends of Houston like singer Chaka Khan tell me the loss is still surreal.
In a state of prayer and love and respect for this woman, this amazing woman.
One of Houston's producers, Narada Michael Walden, holds on to fond memories inside the recording studio.
I'm every woman, it's all in.
And 9 months pregnant, singing that song. So, you know, I have a lot of memories of Whitney.
CNN's Pierce Morgan reveals new insight shared about Houston's private life.
Jennifer Holliday revealed, as far as I'm aware, for the first time that anyone has gone on the record who knew Whitney before she met Bobby Brown to say that she knew for a fact Whitney was doing drugs before she met him.
And I'm told that the performance last week, Thursday night, that R&B celebration, it was a big surprise to see Whitney Houston get up on stage. Many feel honored that they were able to see her there for the last time. We're live in Hollywood, Soraya Fidel, KCAL 9 News.